हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ मिस्टर हरीश सदाशिव मोटेकर। आई एम योर सब्जेक्ट टीचर फॉर द सब्जेक्ट क्रिप्टोग्राफी एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। इन आवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव सीन DES एल्गोरिथम, दैट इज डेटा एनक्रिप्शन स्टैंडर्ड एल्गोरिथम। इट इज़ अ ब्लॉक साइफर एल्गोरिथम विच यूज द ब्लॉक्स एज अ प्लेन टेक्स्ट एंड प्रोवाइड द आउट साइफर टेक्स्ट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ब्लॉक्स एज वेल। It also uses the key as a block, but this program, this algorithm has a drawback that it is vulnerable to the brute force attack. Okay, so it is a important thing to find out an alternate of this algorithm. So the Blobfish, RS5, and triple DES are the some alternatives. So Blobfish is the one of the alternative of the DES algorithm. So let us start with the Blobfish algorithm. Okay, so the learning objective of the Blobfish is, after learning this lecture, student will be able to understand the concept of Blobfish algorithm. Now let's start with the Blobfish structure. So the structure of the Blobfish, okay, it follows the Feistel structure, means again the input will be divided into two parts and the further process will be applied on the each of the part. Okay, now it is a block cipher again, so it uses the blocks of the plain text, and generally the 64 bit blocks are used as a input. The key is scalable. In this structure we use a key which is scalable, means the key size can be vary from 32 bit to 448 bits. Okay, so in the most of cases we use a key of the 128 bits, so we can consider it as a default key. The number of rounds to complete the process is 16, means the complete Blobfish algorithm can have the 16 rounds. Okay, so this is the basic information about the Blobfish algorithm. After this, the characteristics of the Blobfish are, okay, the first characteristic is it is fast. It encrypts the data on the 32 bit microprocessor at the rate of 18 clock cycles per byte. Okay, it is compact. It can run on very less memory. It is simple, as it can be easily implemented because of its simple structure, like it uses the XOR operation and addition operation and all. So it uses the simple operations. Variably secured. It is variably secured because it uses the key of the length which can be vary from 32 to 448 bits. So these are the basic characteristics of the Blobfish. Now subkey and S box generation. This is the next process. So we'll start with the subkey. The key is divided into the, in the first step, the key is divided into the number of keys. In the most of the cases, the key is divided into the 18 subkeys. So 18 subkeys have the same size, and the size of the each subkey will be 32 bit. Okay. Now this subkey key can be stored in the array that is known as K array, and the that is K1, K2, up to KN. Okay, so this is the K array which is used to store the key. Next is the P array, that is used to store the subkeys. So the subkeys can be stored in the P array, that is P1, P2 and up to P18. So as we know that we have 18 keys, so the value of the P array will be up to P18. Now again we divide the same key to generate the S boxes, means S boxes also generate here using the key. Okay, so the size of the each S box will be 32 bits, and each of the S box will contain the 256 entry of the 32 bit, means each will be of the 32 bit, and 256 entries will be there in each of the S box. Okay, as we use a key of 128 bits, so total 4 keys will subkeys will be there. Total 4 S boxes will be there, means each of the 32 bit. So the overall contents of the sub boxes will be 1024 entries of the 32 bit. So this is the sub key generation and S box generation. Now we initialize the P array and S boxes. So initialization of the P array and S boxes is like, so to initialize P array means contents of the P array, that is P1, P2 and up to P18, so that are the subkeys. So the to initialize first subkey, that is P1, the P1 will be XORed with the first 32 bit of the K array. We have a K array which has the number of bits. Out of that, the first 32 bits will be XORed with the P1, and that value will be again stored in the new P1. So the P1 will be initialized. Now P2, so the P2 will be XORed with the second 32 bits of the K array, and that value will be stored in the new P2. Similarly, in the P18, the value of P18 XORed with the 18th 32-bit bits of the K array will be stored in the new P18. So this is the initialization of the P array, okay? And S boxes takes the 8 bit and produce the 32 bit output. So we are initializing the S boxes by the 8 bits, okay, of the input of the key. Okay, now the next is implementation of the blow shift algorithm. So as we know that it is a fistel structure algorithm. So the whole block of the plain text will be divided into two parts, first left part and right part. So here we can see that the left part is that LE and right part is that RE, and each of the 32 bits. Okay, so the 64 bit is divided into two parts. Now the left part is applied to the an XOR operation with the P1, and here the P1 is the subkey of the first round. So the 32 bit L means left input will be XORed with the P1, and the output will be applied to the F function, and output of that F function will be applied to the XOR operation, where right half of the plain text will be XORed with the output of the XOR function. Now these results will be swapped in the next step. So the output of the first XOR will become a new R1, means right part, and the output of this XOR operation will become the new left part. Okay, so this is the first round. In first round, what we repeat the first round, we are repeating the first round. First 64 bit plain text is divided into two parts, and now on the left part we applied the XOR operation with the subkey P1. The output of that is applied to the function F, and output of function F is applied to the XOR operation, where the operation is XORing with the right part of the plain text. Now the output of the both of XOR operations are swapped, so we get the new L1 and R1. Okay, so this whole process will be applied 16 times. Okay, so we will use the 16 keys for each round, but we have 18 keys, so we will use the 17 key in the next round, that is 17th round we are considering here, and 18th key will be applied in the same round but on the next part, that is left part. So we are applying the 17th key on the right part of the output, and 18th key will be applied on the left part. Now after this we will merge both the keys and we will get the 64 bit ciphertext. So this is the whole operation of the blow shift. Now let us understand the round function, that is function f of k. Okay, so what is the function? We can understand here. So see, this is the f function. So what is the actually operation of the f function? Okay, so f function is what doing what? It is actually f function is actually have the four box s boxes, and each of the 32 bit s box means each provides the 32 bit output. As we know as we have seen earlier that we have the s boxes with the 8 bit input and output is 32 bit. So output of first two s boxes will be mod here, means it is addition operation actually. After that, the output of this first operation will be XOR with the third box, and output of this XOR operation will be again mod with the last box. This mod operation is actually the addition operation. So we can understand these two are the addition operation and this is the XOR operation. So in this way we'll get this equation. Okay, so this equation shows f of the function k, that is the function is actually for 0 to 31 bits. Okay, so total 32 bits. So f of k, that is key of 32 bit, so the output will be this. Okay, so in this output we can see s1, which is having the last 8 bits, that is 24 to 31. S2, that is having the second last 8 bits, 16 to 23. Then S3, which have 8 to 15, and S4, that have the 0 to 7. So these are the input of the S boxes, and that input of the S boxes will be performed these operations first. Means here we are applying the addition, after that we are performing XOR with the next key, and then we are applying again addition with the result of this. So this operation can be easily understand using this diagram. Means first and output of first S box and second S box will be first perform the addition. After that, output of the addition will be applied to the XOR operation, where the third S box will be taking part into the XOR operation. Now the output of the XOR operation will be mod with the fourth S box output. So this will be the final output of the first round. Now this first round output will be applied here in this XOR operation with the right part, and that output will become the left part for the next round. So this is the operation of the function f. Okay, now the review questions, means the overall working of the Blobfish function. We have Blobfish algorithm we have seen in this whole presentation. Now we have some review questions. So the review questions, first one is explain the FSTL structure. So we have seen FSTL structure. Explain the implementation of the f function of the Blobfish, and explain how to implement the s box in the Blobfish. So these are the review questions for the lecture, for the topic. Okay, thank you for watching the video. Thank you so much.